In this video, we're going to look at adding a leading edge flap, also known as a slat, onto your airfoil in Xfoil. This will give you the ability to analyze the performance of an airfoil on off-design conditions like takeoff and landing. This video series is brought to you by the Science of Fly, helping you take your aerospace engineering skills to the next level. Let's get to it. As mentioned in the intro, we're going to be talking about creating leading edge flaps, otherwise known as slats. I actually learned this trick in my experimental aerodynamics course where we spent a lot of our time in the wind tunnel. And this is a hack that I learned from my professor there. I call this a hack because what we're doing is we're going to be misusing the flap command to create a slat. And for that reason as well, this video is going to contain a lot of similar information as the previous video where I covered trailing edge flaps. So there's going to be some overlap of material here, but there is going to be some new information. Let's go ahead and review what a slat is and what its purpose is. Basically, a slat, like a flap, is a high lift device to increase lift in low velocity flight, as in takeoff and landing. What you're doing is that you are changing the shape of the airfoil to create different lift properties of the airfoil. When you move the slat forward, you're increasing the wing area as well as usually increasing the wing chord. When you pivot a slat down, you're increasing the camber of the wing. And this has its pros and its cons. It allows you to create more lift in low velocity flight at the expense of also increasing your drag. For this reason, like flaps, a lot of times you'll land with full slats, but you might take off with partial slats, and when you're up cruising, you're gonna have no slats, trying to get rid of that drag and be efficient. So let's go ahead and look at how we can implement a slat in Xfoil to create the effective shape of the airfoil when you deploy the slat, so that you can see what your lift and your drag and your moments are going to look like in the deployed position. Since we already covered a lot of this material in the previous video, I'm going to run through these steps pretty quickly and spend more time on the new steps. The first step is to load your knockoff 4412 airfoil. The second step is that we're going to drop down into the geometric design menu. This is where you go if you're wanting to change your airfoil shape. And as we see there, it tells us we're working with the buffer airfoil. This is important to keep in mind because when we try and run an analysis, we're going to want to move this changed airfoil from the buffer airfoil to the current airfoil memory. The next step would be to use the flap command to enter in the slat information. The first piece of information that we need to enter in is the X location of the hinge point. Remember, this is the distance from the zero axis to the hinge point. So if your leading edge is not at 0, 0, or your airfoil is not normalized to a chord of 1, this value is not going to be the same as the percentage of the chord. But for a normalized chord, we can just type in the percentage of the chord where we want our slat to hinge at. And we're going to want it to hinge, for this example, at 15% of the chord. So go ahead and type 0.15 and hit enter. The next step would be to specify the Y location that you're wanting the slat to hinge at. For this example, we're going to go ahead and put this at about half the thickness of the airfoil. So you can do a quick calculation using the Y location of the top and bottom surface you see there to figure out where the midpoint would be. Or if you type 999 and hit enter, then you can just specify the relative flap hinge location from 0 to 1, 0 being the bottom surface, 1 being the top surface. So for this example, we wanted about the midpoint between the upper and lower surface, so we put 0.5 and hit enter. Now remember, like the X location of the hinge point, Xfoil is looking for the actual Y location of the hinge point. So if you didn't want to use this alternate method and just specify the relative location using upper to lower surface locations, then make sure you're giving the actual Y location of the hinge point. Now, the third piece of information that the flap command is looking for is the angle to deflect the slat. For this example, we're going to go ahead and deflect the slat 20 degrees downward. Now, the secret to this hack actually comes from this angle right here. So remember it. We're going to use it in the next step. Now, this is the extra step that can be included to hack the flap command to do a slat. Essentially, what happened is that we, instead of deflecting the slat downwards, we deflected the rest of the airfoil downward as a flap, and in this step we're going to rotate it back around so that the airfoil is back at a 0 degree angle of attack and the slat is actually deflected downwards. To do this, we're going to use the ADEG command. This command just rotates the airfoil. In a previous slide, I went ahead and told you to remember the angle you deflected downwards in the flap command, because now we're going to rotate the airfoil in the opposite direction. Using the flap command, we deflected the rest of the airfoil down 20 degrees, leaving the slat at 0 degrees. We're now going to rotate the entire airfoil negative 20 degrees so that our airfoil is rotated to be at 0 degrees and our slat is rotated to be at 20 degrees deflection. So go ahead and type minus sign 20 and hit enter. And as you can see, the modified airfoil there in the secondary window, we now have our airfoil with a leading edge flap or a slat. However, we're not done yet. There's still another step. Remember, we have this airfoil saved in the buffer memory, but before we're able to do any analysis on it, we need to move it over to the current airfoil, and we'll do that in the next step. To move our airfoil from the buffer to the current airfoil memory, in the geometric design menu, we're going to use the EXEC command, and that'll transfer our airfoil over so that we can perform analysis on it. At this point, you're ready to go ahead and run your analysis or save your airfoil away with the newly created slat that you added to it. All right, we're going to go ahead and end the video there. Remember L, C, and S. And may your bubble stay small, your flow stay attached, and your drag stay low. I'll see you in the next video.